During Flight 8, it was undoubtedly a feat. Despite the controversy surrounding it, the B-15's successful landing remains undeniable. What lies ahead? How will SpaceX advance, improve, and optimize the B-15? The most important question, can it soar once again? Let's dive deeper in today's episode of NR Studio. SpaceX has undeniably heightened the anticipation by recently sharing a series of captivating footage, images, and videos on social media, meticulously highlighting every exhilarating moment of the B-15's activation, liftoff, and near-perfect landing. It was truly captivating. The entire sequence of events was seamless and engaging, culminating in the final moment of the rocket booster being deftly caught by a chopstick. It appears that SpaceX has attempted this feat on several occasions before. At this point, one can confidently say that they have mastered the technique. However, what made this achievement even more remarkable was the far less turbulent journey the B-15 took compared to the previous two boosters that successfully completed their landings. The B-15 did not suffer any significant engine damage, only experiencing a small fire at the end of the flight. The B-15 suffered the loss of one engine. However, it managed to reignite just in time for a safe landing. The B-15, however, faced a greater obstacle. It suffered two engine failures, with only one successfully reignited. This introduction of suspense heightened the experience for the audience. However, despite the obstacles, the B-15 managed to complete a perfect ending. This milestone marked the third successful landing of a Starship booster, which achieved the remarkable feat of securing two consecutive landings in just 7 weeks. A reflection of the rapid progress SpaceX has made in perfecting its landing methodology. What will happen to the B-15? On launch day, about an hour after landing, the booster's boom was carefully positioned onto the OLM. Simultaneously, the booster's transport bay was strategically positioned, ready to receive the returning hero. By that evening, the B-15 was on its way to the launch site. Then, on March the 7th, the booster was officially undocked from the OLM and positioned onto the transport bay. The boom was retracted, marking the start of its next journey. As per the road closure schedule, B-15 began its journey at approximately 11:30 p.m. Central Time en route to the production site, where it was eventually positioned within Mega Bay. B-15 will undergo a comprehensive evaluation to assess its current condition. The engines will be the focus of attention, having successfully overcome such a daunting challenge. Engineers will focus their efforts on the two engines that failed during the boostback burn, carefully investigating the root cause of the failure. The goal is not just to fix the B-15, but also to strategically apply the insights gained to inform future prototypes. After analyzing the events observed during Flight 8, it appears that the B-15 engine issue bears similarities to the one experienced by the B-14 during Flight 7. The likely cause was an underpowered ignition system that may have prevented the engines from successfully reigniting after being shut down during stage separation. If so, additional improvements to the ignition system will be imperative. Another important focus is the pressurization system that directly affected the March 3rd scrub. Musk indicated that inadequate ground spin start pressure prevented the booster from achieving the thrust necessary for liftoff. While SpaceX was able to promptly fix the issue, it stands to reason that this resolution was only a temporary fix. More comprehensive upgrades to the production facility will likely be needed to prevent a repeat of this issue. As SpaceX continues to optimize the Starship design, each landing provides invaluable insights. The upcoming decision regarding the B-15 will be crucial in determining whether it will make another flight or simply serve as a precursor to future boosters. Regardless, it marks another monumental step toward achieving full reusability. Now that the B-15 has safely returned to the production facility, the pressing question is how SpaceX plans to improve and advance it. A major area of focus is the hot staging system, specifically the clamping mechanism. This mechanism plays a critical role in preventing stacking attempts during pre-launch preparation, and therefore SpaceX must ensure its flawless functionality on future flights. Furthermore, an efficient hot staging system is critical to the smooth integration and uncoupling of the rocket's two stages, which is essential for optimizing stage transitions during flight. SpaceX is expected to continue to improve the ignition system for the engine system, which received improvements prior to Flight 8. However, further refinement of the engine components or the implementation of shielding systems could significantly improve durability and reliability for future flights. However, the real transformative power may lie in the Raptor 3. This next-generation engine has been anticipated for quite some time. However, this engine has yet to be demonstrated on a flight-ready booster. If the B-15 is repurposed, it appears to be an ideal contender for Raptor 3 testing, especially considering that the initial Super Heavy booster was anticipated to make a maximum of 2 flights. Could this finally be the opportunity for the long-awaited Raptor 3 debut? We invite you to share your thoughts in the comments below. The clamping mechanism used in hot staging experienced complications during the pre-flight stacking process. However, this marks the first instance of such a problem being reported early on. This suggests that the solution is unlikely to be overly complicated. It may simply require improvements to improve stability and flexibility throughout the connection and separation stages. Another significant issue requiring attention is the pressurization system, which directly led to the aborted launch attempt for the third stage. It was reported that the spin star ground pressure was below anticipated levels, resulting in insufficient thrust to achieve liftoff. While SpaceX quickly fixed the issue, its emergence suggests the need for a more lasting fix. An effective approach may involve upgrading the turbopump system to increase pump power, thereby ensuring that the booster consistently achieves the required thrust. With careful evaluation and improvements currently underway, future actions regarding the B-15 will be critical to ensuring the final outcome. If the booster passes inspection without significant problems, it has a good chance of becoming one of the first reusable Super Heavy boosters. Regardless of its future flight status, any improvements and refinements implemented at this point will decisively serve the next Starship booster, thus ensuring SpaceX's relentless progress toward full reusability. Indeed, the B-16 prototype, currently engaged in cryogenic testing, could serve as a pilot model to integrate some of these improvements for the upcoming Flight 9. This is a pressing question that many are eager to clarify. At this time, given the available observations, it seems unlikely that the B-12 will be reused. Thus, the most viable contenders for reusability appear to be the B-14 and B-15. Both 14 and 15 have shown potential for future flights, particularly if SpaceX chooses to use them as test platforms for upgrades such as Raptor 3. However, the difficulty stems from the fact that a series of new boosters are ready in quick succession, each anticipating its moment of deployment. The B-16 is currently engaged in cryogenic testing and is the next booster on Flight 9. The B-17 has been fully loaded and is fully prepared for its upcoming mission. Meanwhile, there are indications regarding the B-18, which may mark the arrival of Booster Version 2, a significant advancement in design and performance. As SpaceX focuses on developing newer prototypes, the prospects for reusing older boosters may be limited. If SpaceX chooses to use a single booster, it becomes clear that the B-14 has a marginal advantage. And the reasons for this are as follows. The B-14 has been awaiting repairs since January, indicating that it has a long repair period and therefore can be prepared earlier than the B-15. Plane 1 suffered a single engine failure, while Plane 15 suffered 2 engine failures and will require a more thorough inspection and repair. Nevertheless, the successful landing of the B-15 serves as a strong testament to its enduring strength as a candidate, especially if inspections and upgrades are carried out quickly. What do you think, sir? Do you anticipate the B-15 will have a chance for another flight? Also, will SpaceX focus its efforts on advancing newer boosters? Which Super Heavy booster do you believe will be the first to be reused? Please share your predictions in the comments below and explain your reasoning. Don't forget to like the video and subscribe to our channel to ensure you stay informed with the latest updates on SpaceX development journey. In a further exciting development, as preparations for the Crew 10 mission to the ISS gather pace, SpaceX has officially relocated its Dragon spacecraft to an assembly facility at its launch complex in Florida. On March 5th, SpaceX released these incredible images on X, depicting the transport of the Dragon spacecraft on a trailer ahead of its arrival at the factory. With the readout complete, Dragon has arrived at Hangar 39A in anticipation of next week's launch of NASA's Crew 10 mission to the space station. Upon arrival, Dragon was immediately prepared for its next critical phase, being integrated onto the Falcon 9 for final testing in anticipation of its highly anticipated launch. Currently, the launch is scheduled for March 12th at 7:08 p.m. Eastern Time, taking place at the venerable launch complex 39A, a site that has played a key role in many iconic missions throughout history. The unbiased Dragon will consist of a quartet of astronauts, each from a different space agency. NASA astronauts Anne McLean and Nicole Ayers, along with JAXA astronaut Takayo Nishi and cosmonaut Peskov from Roscosmos, have successfully completed extensive pre-flight evaluations, ensuring their readiness for the thrilling expedition to the International Space Station. Notably, the Crew 10 mission was originally scheduled to use the newly developed Dragon capsule. However, due to development delays, NASA and SpaceX strategically switched to using the Dragon Endurance, a capsule originally intended for an alternate mission. This timely change facilitated Crew 10's adherence to their schedule, avoiding additional delays. While Crew 10 primarily represents a standard crew rotation and resupply operation, it is all the more significant because of its implications for Crew 9, particularly regarding the return of two astronauts to Starliner. Crew 9 is currently tasked with retrieving Butch Wilmore and Suni Williams, two astronauts from Boeing's Starliner mission, who have been living on the ISS for an extended period of more than 9 months, significantly beyond their original 8-day schedule. Various technical complications have prevented their return with the crew, forcing NASA to rely on SpaceX's Crew Dragon for a safe journey home. If Crew 10 launches as scheduled, it is expected to arrive at the International Space Station in just over an hour, landing on the morning of March 13th. The transition phase between the two crews is expected to last a week, with Crew 9 expected to resume duties around March 20th. All indicators suggest that preparations for Crew 10 are going smoothly, and the stranded Starliner astronauts will begin their journey home soon. However, given the minor technical challenges that Falcon 9 has faced over the past 6 months, SpaceX is taking a very cautious approach to launch preparations. That's all for today's episode. See you in the next episode. And we would like to say thank you very much for your support, ladies and gentlemen. Without you all, we wouldn't be where we are today. And thank you for your support.